Cecilia Noël is a spicy, multi-talented Peruvian-born singer who is the reigning queen of salsoul. She not only sings and writes, but also dances and conducts her own band, thrilling her audiences with her sizzling energy.
Money, you will never be free. Oh yeah. Stop playing with a monkey. It's gonna get a little funky. Sleeping with the devil, falling deep in the trap. You've been feeling like a traitor every time you get up.
There's no sense of faking love that doesn't give in.
Come on, tell me, baby, do you know what?
They call you a Peruvian goddess, or at least the queen of salsoul. What does that mean, queen of salsoul?
Salsoul is a term actually that was used in the 70s and that we're trying to bring back because I think it's a wonderful way to describe the music that people like me that grew partly in the United States, you know, and we have all these influences with American music, especially funk, soul and rock, and with our Latin roots, so it's like the salsa and the soul music. So,
you go back a long ways, and you have influences from a variety of genres and countries. Where did it all begin? Where are you originally from?
I was born in Lima, Peru, and it all started as a child. I mean, probably when I was like 2 or 3 years old, listening to James Brown and Tower of Power. And Jimi Hendrix.
Oh, gosh.
And, you know, Paris Prado, all kinds of stuff. My family was very much into music and the arts.
Talk to me about your mom.
Oh, my mommy.
Your mother.
I lost her last year.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah. But she was the biggest influence in my life. She still is. And she encouraged me to, you know, follow up my dream and be who I am, you know.
And you,
the crazy Cecilia Noël.
Crazy, and if only she was glamorous, honey, and if only the men liked her. Hello, you really go for it in the concert. What energy. Wow, have you always had this energy? I bet you were a high-strung
always,
kid.
I was a terrible, terrible, badly behaved kid. Always. There were teachers that would walk into the classroom and go, Noël, out of my room.
Oh, yeah.
That you were a descendant from one of the Inca chiefs. Tell me about that.
The cacique Sacha. He actually was an accountant for one of the last Incas, and to be that, you had to be blood related. And the great thing was that when the Spanish came and conquered, he flew to France, where he became the violinist of the court of Louis the 16th.
Wow.
Hey, amazing. The first musician that I know of in my family. And then, you know, he went back, he married a French lady and went back to Peru. And that's how our family continued.
Wow.
Interesting.
And you have an amazing great aunt, I read. Tell me about her.
Yeah, almost a saint, about to be a saint. Yeah. Rafaela de la Pasión. Fantastic. I have her picture in my dressing room.
Now,
I always have it.
Now, why? Because of her good
She was like the first Mother Teresa of South America, and she was born in Ecuador, and I discovered her a few years ago. My mom always talked about her, but just recently I visited the convent when I went to visit my mom one of the last times, and they have a huge convent where they help bad girls like me get on the right track.
Oh, you're so bad. You like to tell everybody you're bad. Jesus, sweetheart.
Stars, gathering the children,
righteous in the water to revive the land.
One of the only female conductors slash songwriters slash singers slash professional dancer
performers.
What else?
Yeah. I mean, clowns.
It goes on and on and on and on. Tell me about your conducting. Where did that start?
Well, I always did. Since I was, you know, my first TV show was when I was 8 years old. I auditioned for a TV show in Lima, Peru. And immediately I took charge of the rhythm section and started telling them what songs I wanted to perform that were usually in English, you know. And I would tell them where they're making mistakes and change the chords. The chords and stuff, because mm-hmm. you know I studied music when I was a child.
You had a good ear, didn't
with
you?
Piano and violin. My mom, you know, was very serious about me getting a good musical education. So I study a variety of instruments. I don't play any of them good, but I know enough so that I can tell my band what I like and what mm-hmm. I don't like. And it's more like a leader mm-hmm. kind of thing, you know, and you have to be strong to conduct a bunch of animals like yeah. the wild clams.
Que te va a castigar.
Ay, dice que todo en la vida tiene un final. Todo en la vida te va a costar.
No me hagas llorar. Que tu conciencia es la que te va a castigar.
Por quien tú me has confundido, va. Por quien dime la verdad.
No me hagas llorar. Que tu conciencia es la que te va a castigar.